Welcome, Hi Chinese.
Okay, never mind, I guess. Okay, I was thinking that this is going to be very informal. No, it's not. My question is about it. But it was supposed to be very informal. I didn't realize it's going to be like a Mark Zuckerberg. I'm like, supposed to be like Steve Jobs trying to explain things there. So I'm going to pull lots of nonsense and I'm going to point. Okay. Where am I supposed to point at? Okay, I guess before I go and tell you nonsense about what to write, I'm just going to read something first. Okay, these are some words from Peter Buck, Michael Mills, William Barry, and Michael Stipe. Night swimming deserves a quiet night. The photograph on the dashboard taken years ago, turned around backwards so the windshield shows every street light reveals a picture in reverse. Still, it's so much clearer, I forgot my shirt at the water's edge. The moon is low tonight. Night swimming deserves a quiet night. I'm not sure all these people understand. Okay, then I'm going to bore you with... So when Enoch asked me to give a tip, and I didn't realize that I gave quite a lot of nonsense. So the first one is write what you don't know. Okay, so okay, why write something you already know what it's about? I believe that it doesn't mean that you should write what you that you shouldn't write what you know. But it should be a means, you know, writing what you know is a means to an entry to the mystery. The work should not be 100% my missus, should not be a projection of what's going on in the day. So you shouldn't just write a poem about botany or travel or delicious food. You should write about what goes into the unknown mystery of it. So don't indulge in wax lyrical. If you want to write about food, write a food review. Okay, I think just now, I think Cyril said that if you're going to work very hard, then don't write about it. But obviously, the truth is that writing is tough. And it's a cliche, so you should write when you don't even have inspiration. The truth is that writing, I mean, I do it as my job. So you should write when you don't have inspiration. Why? Okay, according to what I wrote here. What poetry is not, it isn't a diary entry, okay? It is not description for the sake of description. And there's of course such a thing as objectivist poetry. I don't know if some of you, do you read William Carlos William and Louis Skofsky? This is what they say, you should write about an object and should write it as clear. And of course that is description. But the truth is that there's also selective information. So it's not exactly neutral. So information has to be sieved and carefully calibrated in a poem. And I think the worst kind of poetry is that it falls into a cliché auto mode, that you know from line one that it's going to be a sad poem, that it's going to be an inspirational poem, that it's going to be a confessional poem. I think that's the kind of worst kind of poem you should not write. It should not be predictable, self-satisfied, and gives you a kind of chicken soup kind of, oh, okay, life is short, so seize it, you know, that kind of thing. Don't write that kind of poem. I don't like that kind of poem, okay? Okay, so why you should write when you don't have inspiration? Because, according to what I wrote here, writing is a physiological and neurological phenomenon, meaning it's like a muscle you have to exercise often to do strange, unusual things. Otherwise, writing will get repetitive, lazy, uncommitted, prosaic. No offense to Tak Teh Hao. It's important to step outside your comfort zone, so discover new aspects of your muscle. You should not write things that you already know, because that's very boring. You know how many tips I've given already, but never mind. Okay, another tip I say is that you should write down anything that you see outside. So it can be advertisements, road signs, slogans, news headlines, what else, nonsense, over lyrics, over chit-chat. Anything that made you, sit up and pay attention. Why? Because we should not just write things that we associate with poetry. You write poetry, then you use all these chim words or lyrical words, it gets very boring. So I suggest you should use expression that you don't normally associate with poetry. So, but of course, it should not be solipsistic, it should not be indulgent. You should use a notebook or a tattoo notebook, like I think Mika says so, right? Or you can use a smartphone. Not very smart with me, but well, smartphone. So take down everything you come across that intrigues you. You know? So that could be anything. It could be anything, like, basically. And then you try to imbibe it and transform whatever you learn. And the last tip. If it still bothers you at night, you should write about it. Why? Because it's like when you go shopping, right? You want to buy something and you don't really know whether you want to get it. But let's say girls want to buy something from H&M or MacBook Air, and you wonder whether you have done money. But you still think about it in the middle of the night, that means it's something that you want, and therefore you should write about that. So you should give it time, and then if it really haunts you, bothers you, then that's something worth buying and therefore worth investing in. So same for poetry. That's it. Have a nice day.